The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he spoke about a man. And this man, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had never ever met in his life. He never met this person. And he told Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, "Oh Umar, there is a man from Yemen and his name is Awais al-Qarni. When he comes, ask him to make dua for you." Who was this man? Was he a prophet? Of course not. Was he a companion of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He was not, because he had never met the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In fact, this person was a tabi'i. He was a person who was among those who met the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he was one step lower than the companions. The question now comes, is why did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tell the second Khalifa of Islam, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who was guaranteed paradise? The people would say, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhumah. They would mention the three of them together. He was like one of the best friends of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about Umar, Umar fil Jannah, Umar is in paradise. But yet he tells Umar, "Oh Umar, when this man Awais al-Qarni comes from Yemen, ask him to make dua for you." Who is this Awais al-Qarni? This man, my brothers and sisters, was a person who had elderly parents, and specifically an elderly mother. Imagine you're alive and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is in Medina. Imagine in your lifetime, how would you feel? For a few seconds, just think about that. That you're alive right now and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is also alive. Would you not go and see him, yes or no? You would love to go and see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That would be your dream. That would be your biggest dream. But this man, Awais al-Qarni, his mother said, "You can go, but you have to go for one or two days and then come back. You can't stay there for a long time. That's the one condition I put on you." So Awais al-Qarni, he makes this trip all the way to Medina from Yemen. And there were no aeroplanes, no coaches or cars. He made the trip through the desert. And when he got to Medina to meet the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not there. He was on an expedition. So the Prophet ﷺ was going to return, maybe 1 week, maybe 2 weeks. He's going to come back. And you've made this long journey. But what does Awais al-Qarni do? He remembers the promise that he gave his mother. And he turns around and he heads back to Yemen. And he never ends up meeting Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wahi, revelation, and mentioned Awais al-Qarni through Jibreel alayhi salam to the best of creation sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so much so that he tells one of his best friends, Umar radiallahu anhu, that when this man comes, ask him to make dua for you. My brothers and sisters, look at this deed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given such a high status to in Islam. This deed of showing kindness and goodness towards your parents. This is a massive act of worship that is forgotten.